Keto. I come from Khonkan Village, a South Bilingual school. And today I am very proud to be making a speech about how we can lead forward towards autism. Friends. Friends are nice. Everybody needs friends and good neighbors. On August 8, 1967, a dream was created. A dream where all Southeast Asian countries can join together as one. A dream where these Asian nations lacked in fighting and instead lived together in peace and harmony, promoting economic growth, social progress, and cultural development. This dream started off with only five nations, which was Thailand, Singapore, Malaysia, Indonesia, and the Philippines. In 1984, Brunei joined on in this dream. In 1995, followed Vietnam. And in 1997, there was Laos and Myanmar. And finally, in 1999, there was Cambodia, which makes up the 10 nations of the ASEAN and the 10 bundles of rice that you can see on the ASEAN flag. Over the past 40 years, ASEAN has successfully accomplished many aspects, such as in the summit meetings that is held every 2 years. These aspects include building a peaceful atmosphere for the coexistence of the region, seeking effective resolution for the Thai and Cambodian border dispute, and also creating the AFTA, or the ASEAN Free Trade Agreement. In my speech, I will be talking about the three main pillars of ASEAN. I will also be talking about its importance and what we benefit from it. I will also be talking about things that we should be wary of. So first of all, let's talk about my first main point, is social progress. Which I will be splitting up into two main points, which is social progress as personally and social progress as a whole. Personally, I think we all are very familiar with. Let's give an example of Thailand and Cambodia. The resentments, the fight, the blood, and the revenge. By joining ASEAN, we are having the opportunity to understand each other. We are given the opportunity to forgive each other. And most importantly, we are given the opportunity to understand each other's differences and to lessen the tension between our countries. As a whole, when ASEAN speaks, it doesn't speak for one nation, it speaks for 10. And that, ladies and gentlemen, offers a much greater, a much larger voice into the international stage. We are able to collaborate with each other when we have problems, or we're also able to share our ideas with each other. Which moves on to my second point. When we have forgiveness, we have teamwork, which moves on to cultural development. Now, by joining ASEAN, not only are we keeping our cultures inside our borders, but we're sharing our cultures with everyone else. Look outside, ladies and gentlemen. We have different cuisines from different countries being shared with Thailand. Not only is it being shared with the rest of the region, but we are also keeping our cultures alive. We're showing people the importance and beauty of it. Which moves on to my third point. From teamwork, we move on to trust, which is economic growth. ASEAN seeks to accelerate the economic growth, not only through partnership, but through equality. By allowing these nations to work together, we're allowing them to accomplish things they couldn't accomplish when they were alone. Also, by creating the free trade agreements, we're incorporating these nations into one single market, which is stronger and with a larger population. With one single market, we could bring foreign direct investment into our country, improving the currency and also improving our life standard. How does this improve? First of all, we as regular people receive different products at a cheaper price. Also, we are given much more employment. People in different countries get to work in Thailand as well, thus improving our income. By improving our income, we also improve our living standard. Now, what things should we be wary about? What about the instability of our global markets? Since Thailand is a very strong market, what if Cambodia and Myanmar are very dependent on our market, that they don't do anything to help us? Also, what about the bailouts? Will it happen the same thing as the European Union, where when a financial crisis is struck, will we have to bail out other nations? Will we have to use our money to help these nations? Also, what about the specialization that is happening right now in the economy? Since Thailand is so dependent on rice, and if the rice in Thailand, the markets in Thailand fall, will ASEAN fall down with it? But ladies and gentlemen, these are the things we should be worried about. one community towards one vision. Thank you.